Because our long-term strategic interests and our national and homeland security are at risk. Because so many of America's sons and daughters in our armed forces are in harm's way. I did not hesitate when the President asked me to return to duty. In my view, all options are on the table in terms of how we address this problem in Iraq, in terms of how we can be more successful, and how we can, at some point, begin to draw down our forces. We are not winning, but we are not losing. But I want to make clear that pertains to the situation in Iraq as a whole. Our military forces win the battles that they fight. I, Robert Gates, do solemnly swear
that I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic. Congratulations.
I can guarantee you all, I didn't come back to government after all this time to play any kind of politics. I'm going to do what I think is right, and at least in terms of the advice I give the President and whatever decisions I'm making, I can guarantee you that my decisions and recommendations won't be shaped by politics in any way, shape, or form.
What we have to do is look at this over a period of time, and that frankly just requires patience on our part. I mean, we're as impatient for this thing to turn in a positive direction as anybody, maybe more so. I'd give anything to have to stop doing as many of these condolence letters as I'm writing. It's a terrible thing, and people are suffering. But we can't turn it around overnight. And we just have to have the patience to let this play out. Every evening, I write notes to the families of young Americans like Doug Zimbiak. For you and for me, they are not names on a press release or numbers updated on a website. They are our country's sons and daughters. I have cautioned that no matter what you think about the origins of the war in Iraq, we must get the end game there right. I believe we have now entered that end game. I would define success in Afghanistan as a situation in Afghanistan where it is no longer a source of terrorist threat or extremist threat to the United States or our friends or allies. But I believe that we should be very cautious in having very long-term, very idealistic aspirations in Afghanistan, and rather focus on what we think we actually can accomplish within the next 3 to 5 years. We are not going to do what we did in 1989 and turn our backs on Afghanistan, but what we would hope is that within a reasonable period of time that we could begin transferring responsibility for security over to the Afghans as they are capable of taking responsibility for it. And begin drawing down our forces.
I just want you to know I think about you every day. I feel your hardship and your sacrifice and your burden and that of your families more than you can possibly know. You are, I believe, the best our country has to offer, and you will be in my thoughts and prayers every day for the rest of my life. Thank you.